So the engineer should have told us what, how he constructed this thing.
Get that? Regional Vehicle Maintenance Workshop Soroti was commissioned by John Martin Zopoza Chola Esquire, Inspector General of Police, on 15th November 2021.
Are you done?
Yes. But what are you?
No, I don't.
Well done.
That's what he's calling the other one.
seen, much as the building is clean and it's wonderful, let us also see that the services rendered to the people should also be clean for the good of the people.
The square, Inspector Regional Police, on 15th November 2021.
We shall go for tree planting. This must survive. My tree, this is my tree.
Leaders, and now we have a resolve to work with the police officers to ensure that we avert, we fight terrorism. IGP, we know what the police is doing in the area of fighting terrorism. If it was not for you, we would be suffering. Very few people understand it, but the ones who are present here know how much you are doing. Sometimes under thick and thin, under deplorable conditions, that I don't want to blame anybody for, but that is the situation we are in now. Thank you very much.
I want to thank, first of all, the police. It might have not been all gone well with everybody, but my police of Soroti and the police of the region did a wonderful job in enforcement, in coordination, and in all other aspects. Therefore, this cannot go unnoticed, and this therefore has to be thanked the police and the UPDF fraternity and everybody, stakeholders who played a key role. As you are aware, we are concluding today the mass vaccination that, in the wisdom of His Excellency President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni and the Minister of Health, so it wise that Lango region and Acholi and Teso region should champion the mass vaccination of those 18 years and above. And I want to tell you, from last Monday to today, we have been going on with the campaign, and up to today it is going on. And I want to say, at this particular venue where you are, if you know you have not vaccinated yourself, please take it a point that from here we have all the vaccines required for you.
Our mayor, district, Stoke City Management, Sister Forces representatives, religious representatives, RPC and your team in the whole region, all protocol observed. I'm Commissioner of Police Wayami Sir Felix, Deputy Director of Logistics in charge of construction, estates and land management. As you have heard, I'm supposed to explain what was done, and others will be talked about by our bosses. This region, this Choga, has received this magnificent structure to assist in policing, and this is the main objective of our IGP and the top management, to provide conducive environment for work, and we are going out ahead to ensure that whenever we are constructing, we also add accommodation. Now for this case, due to the conditions that require our mobility, we put the vehicle maintenance center. And so far, this is the first of its kind to be open, because this was the first beneficiary. Second one is the Barara area and then Guru. So that means from Soroti we shall extend to Moroto to Kidepo. Our guest of honor, sir, the construction of regional police headquarters has been done in this financial year of 2020, the last financial year of 2020 and 2021, and it crossed to this financial year. The location of this site is in Soroti, which is 334 kilometers from Kampala. And where we are, this structure is occupying 1,353 square meters, and it is in police land. The structure has a space for both the region and the division. As we toured, we observed that the upper part is regional headquarters, the lower part is district headquarters. We all went through and saw what is up there, but the most important thing that we are trying to phase out in the bucket because of human rights. First, I've observed that has been the bomb on our side from the human rights within the cells. So that bucket issue is being phased out. And we thank the police management for this consideration for our people, for our citizens. In addition to the structure, we see we are fenced off, but on a long run, we have to come back and fence off the whole barracks. We do this because there is a lot of land grabbing, so we try to secure our area.
We are constructing regional headquarters, maintenance centers, and district police stations, including a few accommodation units. I say few because of the resource envelope that we have. Of course, our demand is very wide. Currently, we have an accommodation gap of 49,000 units. And these 49,000 units are supposed to accommodate officers from the rank of PPC to inspector. But the money that we get can only construct an average of 200 units per year. That's why I'm happy that we have the most leadership here, the political leadership, to lobby. They need to lobby so that police gets more funding and we are able to adequately accommodate our police officers. Not just adequately, but decently. Of course, when we are opening when the chief guest was opening the facility, the issue of corruption came up. What we are providing is what they call in ICT the hardware. But what is more important is the software. You can have this, but if the software is bad, nobody will come here for your service. What does it mean? It means we need to clean ourselves. Our hearts, attitude, should also be whitewashed. Those who believe in the Bible, Jesus washes our hearts as white as what? So,
This structure is white, I believe, clean. What about the software that will be inside? And that is where now our focus should be, the issue of corruption. The IGP is very pertinent about improving your welfare. And that's why we are here.
It was entirely done by the police construction unit. If we had gone out there and contracted, I'm sure this would cost not less than 2 billion. But as a police construction unit, we are not after profit. We come to serve the country. So we get materials and construct by ourselves. So we have done this work as police officers, save the casual workers that we get around, the rest of the people, all the technical expertise comes from the police. We have the civil engineers, the electrical engineers, the architects, we have the surveyors, all the people that have worked on this building are purely police officers.